I know these guys better than I do. I know I've known them for a few years, but you've known them for a lot longer than that. And so you probably know the story more than I do. I don't know. I've only heard snippets that Spencer was a long time coming. Now, I don't know how long, but I can relate very much to that. The feeling of waiting and waiting and waiting. Now, I don't know what it's like for people that decide they want to have kids and the next month they're pregnant and they have kids. I don't know what that feels like. I've got a brother and sister I can ask that about. But I know the joy that hits when you've been waiting for so long. And you can see that on the faces of these two. Just the joy, the smiling of, this is actually going to happen for us. And then it did. And Spencer came. That looks so peaceful. Awesome.
That is awesome.
And meeting Doreen and Laura, and I heard about the waiting before anything actually happened. And then this baby came, and to wander in, and I was thinking to myself, now, everyone who's a parent, and who was a parent before Spencer came, was seeing Doreen and Laura and thinking to themselves, I don't know if we told you, we're thinking, they don't know what they're in for. Who thought that? Hands up, be honest. Who thought that? We were thinking that. Now, it can go a number of different ways when you have a child. You can have one that likes to sleep and to do everything that you want them to do. And you can have the opposite to that, who when you want to sleep, they scream. When you want them to be awake, they scream. And that's a possibility as well. Now, I didn't experience that. I had very much, I don't know if it's luck or what it is, but a child that was very similar to Spencer. I'm looking at him just being peaceful. And that's a major blessing for you guys. It's just sensational. And it's not just a blessing, it's also a credit to you guys. Because there's a lot to do with how you treat them. I know there's a lot that's out of your control. But there's some that is, which is great. I want to read a Bible verse out of Matthew. In Matthew chapter 18, it says, Jesus called a little child to him and stood the child before his followers. Then he said, I tell you the truth, you must change and become like little children. Who'd like to change and be like Spencer is right now? Just, it'd be nice, wouldn't it? Carefree. It says, I tell you the truth, you must change and become like little children. Otherwise, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. The greatest person in the kingdom of heaven is the one who makes himself humble, like this child. Whoever accepts a child in my name accepts me. Those are big words. Watching Spencer come into your family and just the love that you've got for him and the acceptance. It says if you accept this child, you accept God. I'm missing out. I should step this way, shouldn't I? And that goes for everyone here. Everyone here who accepts this child and every other child accepts God, which is a big deal. But there, it comes with a warning a little bit further down. It says, be careful. And this is more for us. It says, don't think these little children are worth nothing. I tell you that they have angels in heaven who are always with my Father in heaven. Which is fantastic to know that Spencer has an angel who sees the face of God. It's amazing. And the face of God that Spencer is going to see is going to start with these two faces right here. But it's going to spread to every face that is here today. I know there's a whole lot that have come just for the dedication, which is sensational. You're a really big part of Spencer growing up and what he's going to see. And I love that he's going to see you guys being involved in conviction. You go and you sing in lots of different churches. I don't know if you know, I've had Dorian at Bindu preaching for me a couple of times, which is pretty cool. Next time he goes, we should tell you all so you can go. That'd be great. Church is not big enough? No, not for this many people. This is true. So just before we have a prayer, I'd just love to invite anyone who is family and friends of Doreen, Laura and Spencer to come up front. Just to come up and we'll gather around them just to have a prayer of dedication. So it's a prayer of Doreen and Laura dedicating their boy to God. But it's also them committing their lives to be an example for Spencer, which is a pretty big deal. I think there's going to be a lot. Let's step forward a little bit. So the dedication is something that is asking a blessing on Spencer from God, but it's also a blessing on the family and on the extra. coming, and the friends, and the extended family, which are my good babysitters. Yeah, absolutely, which is good. I heard them while you were up here singing that Spencer was being looked after by your brother. Did he pass the test?
No, it was Dad.
Oh, trusty Dad. Absolutely. That's fantastic. Dear Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for this life that is in my arms that you created. You created Spencer in Laura's womb. Your Bible tells us that. You created him with plans to prosper him and just to do wonderful things through him this life. I want to ask a special blessing on Spencer, that the Holy Spirit can come down and fall on him, and that his potential that you built into him, that can come to fruition as he grows. I ask that you be with Dorian and Laura as they parent Spencer, as they do the best they can, as they get it right sometimes and probably not some other times, because that's what happens with parents. But Lord, I ask that you be with them, a special blessing on Dorian and on Laura, and on their spirit, that they can just give the best love and example of you to him. I thank you for the family and the friends that are here as well. I ask that as they watch and help Spencer grow, that you can just be with them so that the example, the guidance, the love that they can give will be felt, and that Spencer knows truly that he is loved and that he's a gift from you. So I ask a blessing on this family, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.